All right, hello everyone and welcome to the London session. London Cash Open will be in 33 minutes. We're short on a bearish breaker, so that is a high, a low, and a higher high. That black candle there is our point A to point B, and we're aiming for the nearest sell side liquidity at 673 spot 25, and then one contract down at 667 spot 25. Stop is currently above, just above the midpoint of that green candle. Well, might take a loss on this. I saw the body of that candle respecting what I think here is a breaker, and so that's why I got short. Could still be drawing up to fill in new week opening gap as well. And we'll just wait from there. Yeah, I'm going to leave it how it is. We're going to get stopped out on this. I will put it just above that green candle there. That's as high as I'm putting it. Two ticks above that high. That's right at new week opening gap. We'd like to see, preferably, the bodies of the candle respect the breaker. High, low, higher, high. Minutes to the London Cash Open. Okay, so we did get a close above the breaker, which is not what I wanted to see. Yeah, I'm just going to get stopped out on this, and wouldn't want to see it go bump new week opening gap again. I gotta put it above that high. I really hate doing this. That's really where it has to be. Yeah, so you see high, low, higher, high. That is a bearish breaker from point A to point B. Alright guys, let me show you the executions. You see we got short up here, covered one here, and covered one as the market came back up here. So we've been working this range, and we're sitting up 2172.60 on the day. So we've got a little bit less than $1,500 to go for our profit limit. I'll be back when I get another setup. Twenty-seven minutes into the London Cash Open. Yeah. It's not looking good. Not looking good at all. This one's probably going to be a loss. Yeah, reacted off that black candle there. All right. Well, unfortunately, that was a loss, but we will keep trading. Just going to wait for the market to put in a top. Turning back into this SIBI here. We will get short again, three contracts. We're up 1648 now. Thought that was going to be a bearish breaker. Did not work out. So I'm just going to let the market decide where it wants to put its high. All right, guys, this is the London session. We took a loss. I think that was 500. little volume imbalance there. Short three. London cash open in 5 minutes. We're currently sitting, we're down. We took a loss. We traded up into this bear shorter block up here. It's really a mitigation block, right? High, low, lower high. That would be a mitigation block. We traded up into it. So you can see that the closes respected that volume imbalance there. We redelivered and rebalanced. We are rebalancing that new week opening gap now. So we should be clear to go lower. Maybe for this and this. It's also one standard deviation. Okay, so once it gets funky on me, I'm just going to put it above that bearish order block for now. I feel pretty good about that high, though. We just ripped into buy stops. We're working that new week opening gap now. London Stock Exchange opens in 2 minutes. Next candle is London Stock Exchange. And I grabbed more buy stops. So I had to move the stop. Notice the candles closes, the bodies, the candle bodies. Okay. Notice that the candle bodies are respecting that volume imbalance to the left thus far. All right, we're going to be stopped out again. Or maybe not. Grab more buy stops. All right. See if they want to come take some sell side out now. Working back through a new week opening gap. sell side has been sitting pretty for a few hours now. Let's see if they want to go push some of that sell side out. We just took out buy stops. Oh, ow. Oh, what was that? Oh, my. It's doing some crazy stuff right now. Oh, my. Ouch. Okay. I do not feel good about this at all now. I really don't know how to interpret what just happened there. Well, we're starting to pick up some speed. I'll say that. Picking up in volatility now. I'm not going to move the stop. We get stopped out. We get stopped out. I put it above the bearish order block. And they've been working these buy stops now for a while. Got an outside candle. Taking out both sides of the book right now. They're working that new week opening gap. I don't feel good about it. I don't feel good about it at all. Ay, ay, ay. London Open doing some wacky jacky stuff. We're short three. Our buy stop is above that bullish order block to the left. Our buy limits to the downside are on sell side liquidity and one standard deviation lower, taking those candles as a implied bullish bearish order block. We're working those buy stops right now, working the buy side liquidity. I feel pretty bad about this. I do think I'm going to be stopped out. The 5-minute London cash open candle is funky, funky, funky. An outside candle. I do feel like we're going to be stopped out on this. All right. Down to 11.85 on the session. Just redelivered that sell side imbalance, buy side inefficiency to the left. We're short three. see that market. Let's see if the close respects that wick inefficiency. Inverted wick, CE. Kind of looks like it wants to. Inverted wick over here. Getting some reaction from price off that. Currently sitting up 1223 with open profit. We were up 2100. Very unfortunate. Y'all did see some losses. Is what it is. That wick CE. Does appear the price is initially respecting it. No, rejection block, and then the next wick and then we're being stopped out again. Yeah, it's moving now. Alright. We are moving now. See if we can start getting some 1 minute candle closes below the wick CE. That would be a good start. Price has beat up that buy side liquidity now pretty good. We're at rejection block. Turning into that top wick. That 10 minute close of that candle initially respected this rejection block. Trading higher, unfortunately. We're at rejection block, and then we're working into this wick. Buy side imbalance, sell side inefficiency forming below us, large one. See the consequent encroachment of that wick there, and then rejection block was higher. Ow. That hurts. Okay. All right. We're going to be stopped out again. And it's coming up into... Yeah. Ow. Ooh. That hurts. Okay. We're up 676. Took out another high. Should probably stop guessing which one's going to be the high. I'm down on the 1 minute. And it's kind of going crazy right now. So we just took out another high. All right, well, I'm glad I got stopped out. Yeah, man, that hurts. That hurts a lot. We were up $1,500 more than this. That hurts a lot. Seeing things that weren't there. Now the price is running. We're up a lot. Taking out New York liquidity now. It looks like a pretty decent high. Do say so myself. All right, try again. Close of that large candle there respected the midpoint of that breaker. So. Treating that as a bearish breaker. Might have some sort of effect on price. We're up 669. Well, I guess I'm glad that I had my buy stops, right? So, using that as our bearish breaker, two orders at one standard deviation, one order at sell side liquidity. We have thoroughly destroyed the buy stops now. So that is a very strong move on London. But it is Monday's trading now. So identify that that was a bearish breaker to the left from New York. Ran some Friday New York liquidity. Redelivered that sell side imbalance, buy side inefficiency, and we're trading up into this bearish breaker. We do have a wick, consequent encroachment above us. I would look for it to come back to sell side liquidity. That might take some time. Probably will take a long time. So this recording is probably going to be a long one. We were at a very healthy profit, and I blew it. But we'll see if we can get it back. Still at a profit on the day, but not nearly where I was. One standard deviation of that bearish breaker projected lower takes us to 679 quarters. Also takes us... See, lines up pretty cleanly with this sell side liquidity down here. I would expect price. I predict the price will come back to the sell side. But that might be a few hours. Almost certainly will be a few hours, yeah. This is going to be a long recording. So, I'll take a break. I really hate times like this. I got nothing to say. One hour chart, you can see that that move up redelivered that SIBI and traded into that wick right there. Okay, on the hourly chart. The breaker that I'm talking about is 15 minutes right here. One standard deviation of that breaker takes us to my buy limits. Could be a few hours. This is probably going to be a 4 or 5 hour long recording. I'm going to go for a long walk, whatever. If this plays out. Okay. Yeah, I made mistakes. Big time. For sure. I was not looking for this hourly SIBI. But we traded back into it. And overall, I think this should work out. Okay. That's a good time for price to make a high. 0421 is a good time. It appears to be respecting the bodies of the candles, appear to be respecting the 15-minute breaker. So overall, I do think the price should come back down, but it could take hours. So, but I will be here the whole time. right, I'm going to call it there for 30 minutes, an hour. Did end up down 300 on the session, 400. Well,
yeah, I think I will. Well, I want to see if it trades back up in the semi, five resistance.
I've been going for a while now. Take a break. I'm just going to call it a loss on the session. Bye-bye.